The music at Letchworth is extremely good because it was run by a German refugee called Hans Redlich. And Hans Redlich had been a pupil of Elbenberg. He had edited Monteverdi. He'd also edited some of the symphonies of Mahler. And what this poor wretched Viennese Jew was doing at the back of beyond down in Letchworth at the settlement, well, he took what jobs were offered, needless to say. We were very lucky, I now realise, that a man of such cultivation, with such a background, should have landed up there to our very great benefit. And sort of he weaned us off the folk songs, you know. He would give recitals of Schubert's songs with one of the singers. And with the orchestra, he started doing not English folk dances. We were doing, you know, he put on the John Passion. And the Mozart Requiem, I mean, not over-exciting a novel, but of course, in the Letchworth culture, these were great novelties. And indeed, he put on operas. It happened that in Letchworth, the Theosophists had built a school, and the Theosophists had a great deal of money, and this school included an extremely well-equipped theatre. Well, the Theosophists eventually gave up the school, and it was taken over by the Roman Catholics, and it's now called St. Francis College. But the theatre is still there, and he used this to put on. He first put on Gluck's Orpheus, where the rather ample ladies of Letchworth performed the dance of the Blessed Spirits, clad in flimsy garments. That was a sight to see. And he also put on the Beggar's Opera. And my mother was one of what are politely called the ladies of the town, Betty Doxy. And I sometimes wonder about the psychological effect of a growing boy seeing his mother pretending to be a tart.